kwara anyị kwatu anyị n'ala dịka ozughi ha kwada anyị n'ime onunu ebe ha hapụrụ anyị ka anyị nwụọ. Mana ọnwụ egbucheghị anyị n'agbanyeghị na ọtụtụ nwụrụ. Dịka esi kwuo, ọnwụ egbughị iji eji chụọ àjà, emechaa ọ ga-epu ome. Dịka ibe si awa ala ibe, n'ahụ aja ka anyị si wee kwaa ụzọ, anyị pụtara n'ike site n'ọwụwa anyanwụ ma bilie dịka nnụnụ dị omimi ọnyịrị ọnwụ. Tupu anyị apụta, anyị gwupụtara ọla ọcha na ọla edo. Kịta, ha abịala ọzọ ịzọsi ya anyị. Mana ha amaghị ka anyị si wee kwado. Amaghị. Ha kwara anyị, kwatuo anyị n'ala. Dịka ozughi, ha kwada anyị n'ime onunu ebe ha hapụrụ anyị ka anyị nwụọ. Mana ọnwụ egbucheghị anyị n'agbanyeghị na ọtụtụ nwụrụ. Dịka esi kwuo, ọnwụ egbughị iji eji chụọ àjà, emechaa ọ ga-epu ome. Dịka ibe si awa ala ibe, n'ahụ aja ka anyị si wee kwaa ụzọ, anyị pụtara n'ike site n'ọwụwa anyanwụ ma bilie dịka nnụnụ dị omimi ọnyịrị ọnwụ. Tupu anyị apụta, anyị gwupụtara ọla ọcha na ọla edo. Kịta, ha abịala ọzọ ịzọsi ya anyị. Mana ha amaghị ka anyị si wee kwado. Amaghị.
once again, fellow Biafrans, lovers of freedom, men and women of goodwill, conscientious people wherever you are all over the world. I say good morning, good afternoon, good evening, and to some of you, good night, depending on your time zone. This is Radio Biafra Extra, and we are streaming live to Radio Biafra London. Radio Biafra London is being anchored by the deputy leader of the indigenous people of Biafra. His name is Maziru Chioka Fomefo. He is from Abatete. Abatete is in Anambra State, and Anambra State is Biafra land. Maziru Chioka Fomefo is the man who have assured us that he will not allow the heart of this project to see corruption. He is standing in a deputizing capacity on behalf of our Supreme Leader, Mazen Nandi Uku Kano, the Prince of Afari Beku, heir to the throne of Ibeku Kingdom, the one and the only man who stood up to speak for the collective interests of the Biafran people for almost 60 years now. Mazen Nandi Kano is from Afari Beku. Afari Beku is in Umuahia. Umuahia is in Abia State. In Abia State is Biafra land. Very special grace of Chukwuka Abiama. He is the director of Radio Biafra as well as Biafran Television, the one and the only man that commands the loyalty of the Biafran people across the globe. I am George Onyibe. I come from Abo. Abo is in Delta State, and Delta State is Biafra land. And of course, in a time like this, we dare not take a step ahead without acknowledging the Creator. We call him Chukwuka Abiama, for he has sent forth his word and healed all our diseases. He is the one who has set our feet upon this path that we must follow. The very primordial influence that drives us in everything we do. For in the end, he is our hope and stay. Ase nani ni me mao. Ase nani na gwaria o. Eze mase nani ni nyiki o. Uwe biaro buru ezi oku. Imana senani neme mao, chimo asenane na gwaria o, onye nwe masenani ninyike o, onwe biaro buru ezioku, chukwu edema, edema, agbanwe agbanwe, edema, ulilanya ndeso, edema, nzim, onye nwe edema. Ima kwa na uge le lanya neni kwe, iba huwe na chachio, iwe mfuchuku nedema, eze unye mwane nedema. Anye na jage mao, makanezi uku, ne maramae, eho nanya nenake, upe omage, ujuru anyanya dadio, ingwe gimbangwe o, odi unye edekage, ibu wafa, nomega, anye nene, nasena, nede mao. Okwa gebu eche to ubisike o, okwa gebu ikanyi jagaga o, okwa geke waro similile, ime kwa mwanyaga koturu ime o, okwa geyo chineke, uke emirine bubwe, okwa geyo chineke ma, ibuchi anya ija hozoi agada bajiri songoku bioma uli lanya kendi biafra o tanyine riroko na ina baroko ogini kageji turugi yegina agama kuisi ala yegina mo ibuchi chukwu edema Jehovah edema ulilanya ndeso nedema omakai sibi wale o nedema ezi chineke mo nariekele o mbenine isi. And of course, wonderful dear friends, wherever you are, I welcome you this morning again. I welcome you not because you have been or you have gone anywhere. I welcome you because it's yet another time to reevaluate our stand, reconsider our position, and prepare our heart to make the necessary sacrifice to ensure that Biafra is restored, There is no other reason why we are here. Our topic this morning is simply five reasons why five groups killed Biafra to keep Nigeria. There are five groups that are so determined to kill Biafra. And these five groups have five reasons. Of course, it can be magnified, but let's keep it that way. There are five groups of individuals who are so desperate for five reasons to kill Biafra in order to keep Nigeria. I hear people say many things, and sometimes I feel discouraged. Oh, Igbos are the ones doing well in one Nigeria. Igbos are the ones doing well. Why are they lamenting? Igbos are okay. They are better off in one Nigeria. Why are they lamenting? Igbos are this. Igbos are this. In one Nigeria favor Igbo. Why are they lamenting? Igbos are always lamenting. And each time I hear this, I wish I could do something to those people. But I will. It's not just yet. But I will hold my cool. I maintain my cool and I watch them. And so because my child in the school is doing well, I have to overlabor him because he's doing well. But there are five group of people who want you to be killed. They want to kill Biafra so Nigeria can remain. Everybody on this earth, including Biafrans, have the right to know why Biafra keep fighting to salvage herself from the rest of these five group. There are a lot of people who have never heard about Biafra. They don't even know what we are doing here. The only thing they know, if they have ever come across this radio, is these people are complaining about the zoo called Nigeria. These people are complaining about the British government. This is all they know. They can't figure it because everything about us, there are a group of people who want to make sure nobody know. Attempt was made to exterminate us, to wipe us away. They tell you about Rwanda genocide. They tell you about the Jewish Holocaust. But the British government will never allow you to talk about the Biafran genocide. And I can assure you that many Biafrans don't even know what you are talking about. Many Nigerians don't know. But those who feel the pain, those who know, know. And I want to tell you this morning that everybody, including the Biafrans, have the right. They need to know why Biafran keep fighting just to salvage herself. We were born into this war. We didn't make it. It's not our making. We were born into this war. I begin to develop my senses to know that something is wrong. I was born into this war. I never started any war. For those of you who are celebrating the end of the war, we may not have believed our fathers if we did not see what they fought for being replicated in our own time. We may not believe all their story. And so make no mistake about that. And we have lived through this war. I come from a country supposedly where I will be jailed and sentenced without having fair access to the justice system. Where another idiot from the same zoo will come out and tell you he's born to rule and he will commit crime and walk away freely. Where another one have to side evil in order to remain relevant. And somebody is not seeing that you are involved in a war. Like I said, we were born into this war. We have lived our life through this war. Many people have died because of this war. And maybe we may not see the end of this war. But the war continues to rage. But the truth remains that it is a war that we must fight to win. Biafrans, anywhere you are in the world, you must understand that this is a war we must fight to win. This is a war that we must fight to the end. This is a war that no matter what happens, we must fight to the finish. Till this day, every Biafran born, dead or alive, have fought this enemy. Most of them unknowingly. Most of them knowingly up until this day. Many Biafrans are in this war already. They engaged in this war. They have been fighting this war. Most of them are dead. Some are still alive. They are fighting this war knowingly and some unknowingly. but all of them are involved in this war up until this day. And there are many people who do not understand what this war is all about. It is raging already. Both the guilty and the innocent, they suffer alike. But the content of the war is simple. Everything they have done, everything they will do. Five group of individuals for five reasons. They want to kill Biafra and keep Nigeria. This war has been on as far as we can remember. British government, that is the voice of the people in the zoo, in the prison you created. This war has been raging since we were born. It has been on before we were born. We have lived through this war till this very moment. Make no mistake about that. We are not missing words. Five people, like I said, are involved. The British government is at war with Biafra to keep Nigeria. The Nigerian state is at war with Biafra to keep Nigeria. The saboteur groups are at war with Biafra to keep Nigeria. The Biafras also are at war with themselves to keep Biafra, to keep Nigeria. The Inanimous gang are at war with Biafra just to keep Nigeria. They lie too many at times about this war. They make it look as if nobody is fighting anybody. But yet, Biafra bear the brunt. Even though the battle formation changed a little bit recently, it is still all the same strategizing to finish all that is left of Biafra. I just played an audio. Sometimes they re-strategize and make the war look as if it's not about the Biafran. But make no mistake about it. As a Biafran, anywhere you are, all over the war is all about you. The war is targeted at you. The war is meant to destroy Biafra completely and to keep Nigeria. That is how it has been like. They lie to us all this time. Every policy, every law, every institution, every system that have been introduced into Nigeria was targeted at one thing, Biafra. Like I said, we were born into this war. We have lived through this war. Many have died because of this war. Many will still die because of this war. Why? Because the British government are killing Biafrans to keep Nigeria. Number one group, number one reason. Why is the British government killing Biafrans in order to keep Nigeria? When British first terrorists landed in West Africa, in Biafra land, they discover Biafra was blessed with natural resources, with palm oil, with gifted human beings, with gas and oil, with silver and gold, with diamonds, and you name them. So much blessing in Biafra land that I can assure you that 20% of the natural and human resources that God gave to Biafra, they've not even tapped into 10% of it. But British government want all this for themselves. They changed our name immediately. They amalgamated us immediately. They deleted Biafra from the map. They want to keep the oil and gas and palm oil to themselves. They made merchandise out of us in the name of slavery. Britain continued to steal the money. There are other conscientious people who would have stopped British government. But they add all of them into the cabals, which is called the European Union. And so the whole world turned against us through the Britain. We never fought Italy. We never fought Germany. We never fought any country in Europe, only Britain, just to keep the oil. The same greed has made Britain to leave European Union. So that thing they are stealing from Biafra land, only Britain want to enjoy it. Until today, with the media, Britain is fighting us. With its international diplomatic relationship and lobby, Britain is fighting us. Many countries will not stand up to speak today because the very resources stolen from our land, Britain will give it to them to shut them up. America will have to fight to get involved in Biafra matter. Britain will rather divide Biafra land into two and give one to China or Japan in order to make sure our voice are not heard. Britain has killed more Biafrans, more Nigerians than the world can imagine, just to get hold and remain in control of the oil. That is Britain's number one enemy and the reason why it's fighting Biafra. For over 30 years, Britain gave media platform to the Yoruba and the Hausa in one Nigeria, but they never gave to Biafra. But we thank God that they didn't give to us, because with the BBC they gave to us, if IPOB was not here, BBC Igbo would have destroyed all that is left of us. And so, as a Biafran, understand we are at war with British. They can show it or not. British government is at war with us. Not because we came to their land to kill them, not because we undermine their sovereignty, but because they want to steal oil and gas and other resources in Biafra land. They can't keep us down this long, so they conspired against us with so many people who will be looking into. Five enemies and five reasons why we must fight this war to the end. But God is watching all of them. Britain is there just observing. British government is there. The most ridiculous aspect of it is that British government feel he's the one sponsoring Europe, and maybe rightfully so, because Europe feed on the misery of Africa. And along the line, British government become very greedy. They want to keep all the money being stolen from Africa and their colony, as they call it, to themselves. They start fighting to break their out of European Union. Nobody in Europe did anything to them. They are strategizing to hand over the world to the Islamic nation. They are strategizing to keep all the loot from Africa to themselves. Now they have break out of EU, irrespective of the blessing in diversity inside the European Union. But they are the one who's telling you that you have to remain in one Nigeria because of the blessing of diversity. Britain is at war with Biafra. And the reason Britain is at war with Biafra is so they can continue stealing the resources, most especially oil and gas from Biafra land, unaccounted for. They don't pay for it. Number two, and number two reason. The Nigerian gang killed Biafra just to keep Nigeria. No matter what happened in Nigeria today, I have never heard about when Yoruba died for one Nigeria. I have never heard about Fulani Hausa died for one Nigeria. It has always been one Nigeria. Hausa and Yoruba killed Biafra. Hausa Yoruba, in collaboration with the British government, killed Biafra. How did it work? While British government was bribing the whole Europe by forming European Union to make sure the whole European is loosed against tiny Biafra, they were not satisfied. Inside the Nigerian, where they made us a separate nation, they hired contractor against us, the same way Fulani are doing today. They have hired all the Fulani in Africa, all of them are in Biafra land now. The war is still ongoing. Britain knew that he needed an enemy at home, a black man to complete the dirty devil's job for them. They gave the power of governance to the Fulani.
And they made the Yoruba a partner in crime. And today, no matter what Yoruba or Fulani are doing, they don't have it. They are only fighting against Biafra, nothing else.
No Yoruba have died because of Nigeria. No Fulani Hausa have died because of Nigeria. We are the one at war here. Can't you people see it? I call them the Nigerian state. It is amazing that fellow black men are killing us to get some percentage of oil. That is why the richest black man alive is Fulani man who didn't go to school. A Fulani man who I'm not sure he can spell his name. That is why the richest black woman alive of in Africa is a Yoruba woman. She didn't go to school and I'm not sure she can spell her name. But watch all of them. They own oil well in Biafra land and that is how they become the richest. And so maybe Biafrans understand what I'm saying. And then somebody say, Yoruba want to divide Nigeria. Hausa want to divide Nigeria. Can you be that easily bewitched? Can you be this easily bewitched if you ever think that? In the coming days, they will be disgracing themselves. And in the coming days, we will be telling you what they are doing. Number two enemy, who is killing Biafra to keep Nigeria, is the Nigerian people. They have been killing Christians all this while. Majority of them are Biafrans. And now all of a sudden, America know and all that good organization around the world discover that truly they are killing Christians. And what did they do? They said, no, if Nigeria cannot stop terrorism, if Nigeria will continue sponsoring terrorism, we will not allow these people to come into our country. Let them enjoy their terrorism themselves. And that is why for the first time, Adeboye came to protest without saying a word. What is he protesting for? What is he protesting for? Can somebody please give me the record of how many Christians that have been killed? It will amaze you. Shebi the Igbo man was crying. We went to Yoruba land. We bought land from Yoruba. We built church with our money. We finished there. We begin to worship our God. Yoruba say we must worship God in Yoruba language. No more worshiping God in Igbo language. It's as bad as that. Is that not war already? Inside the Nigeria is fighting us. Oh, this our one Nigeria is indefensible. One Nigeria, the territorial integrity of one Nigeria cannot be measured. When you hear Fulani saying that, we are at war. We are at war because my son have to score more than 300 to gain admission into Nigerian university. Fulani just need to go there and make a phone call and he will be admitted into the same university with my child. And the Yoruba have to score lesser. And if you are telling me that aside this interest of sharing the loot with the British government as they were sharing it with the European Union is not a war already, and then I just don't know where to place you. I think you are hypocrites. I think you are worse evil. What are we not seeing here? You mess Igbo man. You shit Igbo man. You since I was born till today. Till today. Because I don't know how to change this gospel. I don't know how to begin to lie that idiots are not idiots because I want them to see me as a good man. But every idiot must go back and repent. I just don't understand for the life of me. Inside one Nigeria, Yoruba are better off on their own. With the desperation of keeping one Nigeria, they form Omoteko. It's good for them. I know and you know they don't need Omoteko in a sovereign Oduduwa nation. Why dying inside one Nigeria? Something is at stake. Fulani love one Nigeria. Fulani are the one feeding us. Fulani are everything. But why dying to be with Biafra? And somebody don't know you are in a war. Somebody talk about the jihadists, the Muslim tactics of deceiving people. We know. We just don't give Muslims mouth. Because that thing they are looking for in Biafra land, they will see it. They will give them feast of pig. They will eat. Until they join Muhammad wherever his miserable body lies. But that is how it's going to be. When the Fulani come and this our one Nigeria, we will defend it with every integrity and integrity. Watch the grammar coming from the Fulani. Just is exactly the same way Britain behave. That is to tell you this is a copycat. They are being removed by the British government. Watch everybody who is against Biafra. Their language is the same. So that is why I tell you, anybody who is advocating for one Nigeria, you are enemy of the people of Biafra. Because they have to kill Biafra to keep Nigeria. Till tomorrow morning, they are still doing it.
Today now, Nigerian judges are with terrorists in uniform, are surrounded everywhere in Afari Biku. Can they do that to the idiot called Emia? Can they do that to any idiot who is ruling in Yoruba in the name of Uni or any nonsense? But of course, they have to do it to Biafrans. And the Prince of Afari Biku for that matter. And somebody don't know we are in a war situation already. The same way they dish out order and humiliate us in our land. Can they do it to Yoruba? Can they do it to our Safulani? That is the second people we are fighting. Nigeria want to kill Biafra. Nigeria want to kill Biafra. You don't get it. They want to kill Biafra to keep Nigeria. Oduduwa was never deleted from the map, though it was not there before. Arewa was never deleted from the map, though it was not there before. Why is it that only Biafra that have been in the map, even before there were anything known as European Union, even before there were anything known as Britain, we were here. We predate them over 5,000 years. How come now, today, now, they deleted our name? And somebody say, I don't understand. How will you understand? Do you not know that Israel was deleted from the map? Who are these evil people? Deleting names of country, changing name of country. What is their intention? And you don't know you are in a war. Without Mazen and the Kano, who would mention Biafra? Nigerian state, make sure you don't mention that name. You will be charged for treason. Our leader was arrested and charged for treason. Why? For mentioning Biafra. He want to divide our heaven, heaven of looters. And you don't know you are in a war because it has not gotten to you. You are knowingly in a war. May the Lord be with you. Number three. Why are the saboteur group fighting to kill Biafra for Nigeria? Who pulls on the man of Imo State? His statement is supposed to make you understand where he's coming from. He's saying, oh, you Biafran Christians, you are all hopeless. I'm bringing in Fulani for you. When he tell you his government of the day, it's a government of Fulani. Don't you know what it means? An international media platform gave interview to late Buhari and say, will this your government be inclusive government? Buhari don't give a hoot about the idiot called the idiot placed by Fulani Alamajiri in Imo State. He said his government cannot be inclusive. It is 5 to 75%. He cannot set them with the same thing. But who puts on them and think he's doing us? These are saboteurs. William Biano, all the people who prescribe IPOB, these are saboteurs. The reason why they are fighting against us is that they have their own percentage like Yoruba of one Nigeria. I can be a millionaire today. I will be a millionaire today. I can today, today. They think we are stupid. We know how Nigeria work. All I need to go now is go, just go to meet one Fulani. Kneel down and beg them, forgive me. You know, he's hungry. He's, I just tell them one lie and then tell them another lie. I know where Mazen and the Kano is. I know how to get all the IPOB member. Oh boy, I'm a big boy. I'm a big boy. Don't say anything. I'll be richer than Owazurike. You think we don't know how it functions? Forget about any other thing. Forget about Aruchuku. We eat the money and die. After all, man, woman born, another one die. We think consign us. But of course, we can't do that. We cannot kill ourselves for ourselves. Only miserable people does that. Why am I saying it? Anybody who allow Fulani to enter your community and kill your people, they make them your governor. Anybody who comes into your community, give Fulani men your land in the name of Ruga, they make them your senators. Anybody who fights sincere people in your land as a Biafran, not to allow Fulani have access, they empower them. And so we now have breed of saboteurs. All they need to do is to just insult IPOB, insult Nnamdi Kanu, talk down on Biafra, and that is it all. Kenneth Okinkwo, who asked him what he was saying? I'd rather chop shit than to for Biafra to come. But who asked him? That is how they make money. Tomorrow now, I don't know where that idiot come from. Maybe it's Enugu. Tomorrow now, you hear, oh, Kenneth Okinkwo is from Enugu. Because what he's doing is showing the Fulanese and the British government with Yoruba, I can betray my people to be relevant. And they are watching him, and they are monitoring all of us. And when he do this, put up this Nollywood movie 2-3 times, I think this should be the 3rd time. And then he will go to the next stage. The next one is they will tell him, oh, yeah, go come and give us your a piece of land in your community. If you can give us, we'll make you the next governor. That is how you that is the only way you prosper. And that is one of the challenges you are facing. Many of the wealthy people in Biafra land, almost 80% of them made their money by selling out their father and their mother. And now they don't want us to be free because they know the day of reckoning will come. Now you see, we have been in this war for a very long time. We are fighting against saboteurs. Saboteurs want to kill Biafra. So Nigerians can remain. And the atrocity will not be looked at. Many children of poor men became millionaires immediately after the war. You think they want you to find out how they made their money. So when they come and tell you, happy moment, those of you, your father were very wealthy. After the war, they became poor. If your father is still alive, go and buy them drink. But those of you who, after the war, your father become millionaire, go and question them. Report yourself. But we are in a war. These people are still fighting us because they don't want the mischievous deed to be looked into. These people are still fighting because they want to remain relevant. I want you to view all these governors in Biafra land, the way they turn hit their head. You will know there is more hope for a fool than to hope in those governors. Just watch all the people who lead Biafra land. Where they get power is to harass you, intimidate you as a Biafra. If one Fulani man go to any government house in Biafra land and threaten the governor will even smile and give them drink. You know, you always call this Fulani idiot good name. Aboki. You think Aboki is an insult? Aboki is elevating them above you. You're just saying, my master. Every name you call a Fulani people, you say it is elevating them. You call them Janjaweed idiot, you put idiot for them. Call them Babiala. Barabu Dambansa. And those ones you are calling Aboki Alamajiri, you are alleviating them. So he doesn't offend them. They threaten any governor. The governor says, Alamajiri, stop him. You think he's insulting Alamajiri. He's praising him. Do you know the meaning of Alamajiri? And then they dash him money. But let it be ordinary man, genuine men and women. You see how your governors dish out order. Kill them, shoot them. We won't take it lightly. We will mechanize you. We will escapulate you. We will odorodize you. These are your people you are supposed to protect. Thunder will fire all of you. And somebody still don't understand we are in a war. Number four. The Inanimous group. They killed Biafra to keep Nigeria. When I mean the Inanimous gang or group, there are many countries in the world based on what Nigeria tell them. They are killing Nigerians across Biafrans across the globe. I do not know for the life of me why Egyptian pilot will come and be bombing on Changa Market, bombing schools. They do fight Egypt. Are we sharing battery with Egypt? These are the anonymous group. Many of them. I do not know for the life of me why President of America, Obama, former President of America, will come and chase a good luck out of office. I do not know. These are the anonymous people fighting against Biafra. Just give me one country in the world. Let me tell you what they have done. When you hear South Africa shouting xenophobia, it's Biafra they are killing. And so immediately they finished the last xenophobia. Jubri actually went to congratulate them for the job well done. So many people, Nigeria will just come out and lie to you. Yes, but without Radio Biafra, we cannot say what is happening. Now the radio is here. Let them come out and lie. By now, they would have denied the presence of terrorists in Afari Beku, in our leader's house. Drone is waiting for them. Camera is waiting for them. Everything is waiting for them. This is their time to do the killing. Our time is coming. They shall kill us. And in the end, we will kill them. Then Biafra will come. And those of you who are saying, oh, they are talking. Let it be, blessed be today that you witness the era of talking. For a day shall soon come when it shall be the era of shooting. Is there anybody who have monopoly over these idiots? We are praying. Let them build more barrack. Let them set up more checking point. We are praying and we are doing follow-up for them. Somebody says something, but they don't understand. The day they will leave our land, they won't even remember to take their pint. We can assure you that. And they are not building barracks or they are built enough barrack, right? Open the border, bring them in. And so there are many people fighting against us. They don't know. They don't even know. Somebody will wake up one day, he say he's a TV, he's a middle bet, he's following Fulani to kill Igbo man. You are anonymous, you just don't know. Has Igbo man taken your land? We've been in a war. That's the one they say in my place, Otalo Kanshi. Ndini jono domenye rimungwem. Eh, ki me gwari we. Wapachane nya jono domenye rimungwem. Ya ha indi wengi se no Otalo Kanshi. They went everywhere. Brazil that were giving them most of the ammunition. Where is Brazil today? Most people would not know why Nigerian refinery can never work. They were all built on Brazilian technology. So if any nut break now, you have to go carry template, take the pass to Brazil, they remove it. This addicted technology. But of course, irrespective of the fact that they strategize the reason why the refinery cannot be built in a modern day technology is another area of fighting war. It was a mistake to put a refinery in LMA, in Warren. And that mistake, they don't intend to do it. That is why they destroyed everything. They are telling you Dangote is building a refinery. And you can't not reason. How many people are we fighting? Today now, there are people whose relative is friend and Atiku. When we talk now, they say, Dankas Atiku, Thunder will fire all of you. Atiku is friend and an Igbo girl. I don't want to call her name until she show herself. Sponsoring the Igbo girl. The Igbo girl is a millionaire now. Relative of this Igbo girl now. They are belay the wire for me. Thunder go fire all of them. The brother says, oh, he's attacking Fulani. You always attacking Fulani. We came here and told you the church is safe. The people managing church in Nigeria are evil. You people are gallivanting, writing idiot, writing against your father and your mother. You are among the anonymous. Oh, Onyibe is cursing Christian, but I'm a Christian. Oh, Onyibe is cursing man of God, but I'm a man of God. And today now, it has dawned on all of you. Your daddy G.O. now is protesting with Nigerian flag without saying anything. Imagine you hear that George Onyibe is a member of PDP. Or Mazen and the Khan is a member of EPC. And is fighting to divide Nigeria. How will you value him? And you want us to respect you, Ndiara. And I say, he's attacking Yoruba. He's attacking Yoruba. Since you say don't attack Yoruba today, what have they done to you? Omotekun. Omotekun is protecting Abo, Ndiara. He's attacking Yoruba. He's attacking Yoruba. We are attacking Fulani now. Very soon, some idiot who are sleeping with Fulani will still come and talk. He's attacking Fulani. Thunder will fire all of you. I think our agenda is to destroy Nigeria. Any other thing more than that, God will punish you. All the money you make, oh, PDP, APC, where did he lead us all of us to? And every day they are cutting down our number. These are the anonymous enemy. There are too many. You can't please them. They just want the free money to be coming. There are many people in IPOB. The moment our leader say we lift off the election boycott, that is when you know that APC are plenty inside IPOB. Thunder will fire all of you. I said, hey, sir, can I go and vote? Did I collect PVC for you? You are asking me, can you go and vote? Did I get PVC for you? Ndara. But these are anonymous. Should I give out a secret to them today? When God wants, let me not just go there. We go to the number five group. Why are Biafrans killing Biafrans to keep one Nigeria? It will amuse you. Most people don't know. Biafrans do the dirty job of killing Biafra. They kill themselves. So when Yoruba go tell me, they come out and tell you, a man shot, killed himself and run away. You think they don't know what they are saying? It looks funny, but it's the truth. Yoruba lie on social media to the extent. They publish one of them. Is it not that their Vanguard newspaper? A man killed Aziz Punch. A man killed himself and run away. And then we laugh. These people, how can a man kill himself and run away? But this is the truth. When you are Biafran frustrating IPOB effort to save you, you are the man that killed yourself and run away. Because there will be no hiding place for all of you. To fight a Biafran, you need a Biafran. You are the Biafran who is killing Biafran to keep one Nigeria. All of a sudden, Fulani empower Chibuike Amaechi. Chibuike Amaechi start fighting Omeha. All of them are from the same village, the same community, the same kindred. And you don't know that Chibuike Amaechi is a man killed himself and run away. Where is he today now? He run away to Yoruba land. Finally, they were able to silence Celestine Omeha. And then another one came out again who would have done a very good thing. Ujesuwike. They still empowered Chibuike Amaechi. He came after Ujesuwike. But the question there is that is Chibuike Amaechi the only politician? But they are the Biafrans that killed Biafra. Now tomorrow they will deny. Oh, we didn't see Ame on Amazonan the Canal House. They didn't go there. We didn't know. Did they not deny about Operation Show of Power that killed that people that led to the death of our king and our queen? Tomorrow they will deny. They don't know. We are saying it now, not because it's of any concern to us, because as far as we are concerned, the king and the queen will be buried. Not because of IPOB or anything, but because that is how we do things. Omena Allah and Odena Allah. Nobody can change the custom and tradition of our people. And so they will be buried. The family will have to bury their father. And if it were to be IPOB burial, if we wanted to make it IPOB burial, you will shoot us. We know your bullet will blot out the sun, but we will assure you we will fight in the shade. When you shoot for your bullet to blot out the sun, I tell you, we will fight in the shade, in the ara. There are Biafrans ignorantly killing Biafra. Do you know if you are a Biafran and you are not telling your children about Biafra, that they are Biafra? Do you know you are part of the people killing Biafra? There is a man that normally comes on air. The daughter is saying Biafran thing. I wish that daughter is a son. These are the things we need. You are there, your son will not ask you, or your daughter, hey daddy, mommy, what is Biafra? He said, don't mind those jobless people, thunder will fire you. You have killed us more than Fulani and Yoruba put together. Because trying to deny the truth will not stop the truth. They're trying to reason on what the injury and affliction that have been placed upon us in the past will not stop it. You just can't run away from it. That is why when you go to Yoruba, they say, are you Igbo? He say, no, I'm a job. They just laugh and they know you are actually a very mature Mugu. And then they go to you, yes, are you Igbo? No, I'm not Igbo, I'm Ikwere. They just carry toothpick for you because you are the real Mugu. You don't fall. Yes, you go there, they say, yes, are you Igbo? He say, no, I'm a Bibio, I'm a Fik, I'm a Nam. No, I'm a Idom, I'm a Northernant. I'm a Gala, I'm a Northernant. They just carry toothpick for you. You are the biggest idiot they have, sir. But when they ask you, as Urobu Shekiri man, as a Biafran that you are you Igbo? You say, yes, I'm Igbo man. And they say, what is your name? You will say, oh, Orikefe. They will be the one telling you, no, you are not Igbo, you are Niger Delta. Because they don't want you to know your power. They don't want you to know how connected you are. So they have to keep you divided in order to make fool out of you. And then you are a Biafran, you are not teaching your children who they are. You are part of the people killing Biafra. Your own is that you are the most miserable among all of them. Because what are you even fighting for? You are the one working very hard to take care of your family. You are the one working hard to pay your bills. And so why are you denying your children the truth about who they really are? I do not know what is wrong with some of our people. For some of you to look like a British government done us this evil, you even rename your children. My sister who called yesterday said something. She said something about her name. They are really named from the village is Arose. Arose. But of course, he has to change the name to Harrison. You know, the guy have to change the name to Harrison. Because when he come out and say, Afanam Warose. And then they say, how can you answer Arose? It's evil. Do you know in those days in my place, if you want to threaten somebody, you will tell the person, Nga Gwagin Amwa Warose ni Joker. Or set yana, the person will run. Ya gua ya pump and play. Nka gua ni me warusi joker. But they don't even know the meaning of Arose. Somebody have told them Ogomo is evil. Arose is evil. And now they are denying their father's name. It's now Harrison. And so his children now are Harrison Willifred. Harrison Majore. Harrison Thunderbolt Ndiara. The name your father gives to you to chase away evil spirit. You are changing it. You are part of the people killing Biafra. But it may be ignorant, it may be stupidly, it may be foolishly, it may be sabotagically, anyhow you want to put down. These are the five group of people who are killing Biafra to keep Nigeria, for your information, and their five reasons. So don't let them deceive you. When they come to you talking about the unity of one Nigeria, our united, you are stronger. You ask them, why is British government running from European Union? They are supposed to be stronger now. Okay, the unity in the strong Ghana is only here in Nigeria. Eh? It's only here the unity in strong Ghana. What is chasing British from the European Union? They don't like the strength in unity again. But you see them coming to tell you about nationhood. You ask them what happened to their nation in the first place. Why are they not proud to defend the Ududuwa nation on their own? Why are they not yearning to defend Arewa nation on their own? Not until Biafra nation is emerged into them. They cannot fight for nationhood. I believe you when they tell you about one Nigeria. Simply ask them this question. This unity. This one Nigeria. This in territorial integrity. Who of whose benefit is it? And of whose expense? Who are the beneficiaries? Who are the beneficiaries? And of whose expense? Freedom is why we are here. Freedom from Nigeria. Freedom. Freedom. Freedom.
Respect freedom. To my leader, Mazi Nnamdi Kanu. IPOP. Our people they for street they suffer. Them they hustle for something to eat. Chukwu Okike bless our land with resources, but we still living in poverty. Chukwu Abiamahe, why are we living with pythons? Chukwu Abiamahe, we are living with vultures. In this zoo, there is no law. No constitution or human rights. Freedom is all we are asking for. Freedom is all we are asking for. You have to free our great nation. We love and cherish. You have to free our great nation, or all will perish.
They carry girl around with the massacre. They kill our people, they say we be animal. No food to chop, no job, no joy. Mama, papa go straight for school, all in vain. Even the workers, no payment. Child was born in suffering, girl in suffering, she die in suffering. In this country, so a pity, a pity. We are not brothers, just let me go. No culture, no tribe, just let me go. Not religion, or the same thing came. Can you tell me what makes us in unity?
Freedom is all we are seeking for. Freedom is all we are seeking for. You have to free our great nation. We love and cherish. You have to free our great nation, or all will perish.
Of course, you are Biafra from anywhere you are, all over the world. You are yet to identify with IPOP. I don't know what to tell you. But this is a fight all of us must fight together. We must fight to the end. We must fight to the finish. We have five categories of enemy who has engaged us in battle. And we have seen the five reasons why they keep fighting us. Choose your stand today. You are here to join IPOP. Send us your name, your phone number, your location to our WhatsApp line. We will link you up with the nearest coordinator. I can assure you, if Britain can run away with all the loot from Africa, leaving the rest of European Union behind, I can assure you that Fulani will run out of Nigeria when the time will come. And the minority in the north will have their land back. And I can as well assure you that Biafra shall be free. Our lines are open at this moment. Our WhatsApp line is 070-815-45642. 070-815-45642. Our direct line is 081-221-52971. 081-221-52971 is our direct line. And the special number for the female is 081-288-58614. Special number for the female is 081-288-58614. It is time for us to go home. Everybody must prepare to go home. You must disassociate yourself from these five groups who are fighting Biafra in order to keep Nigeria, because they will not survive.
caller on the line, your name and where you calling from. Monitoring spirit, good morning from here.
Oh, my only good to cook Gadia Matrix. How well can I can we see? I see book of Babu. Oh, your Sassin at the Afra, Tahatia. Oh, your Pulosiana Rodot at the Afra, Tia. Oh, your Pulana, not an IP of you. Oh, on your Boburu to Syria. Oh, Catapana and Rotam Mayo. He said. We know that we are going to face the war. Yes. It is either we get Biafra now or never. But it is a lie. Come, shut up. We must get Biafra. All of us are suffering. Is it not true? We are there in exile. Second, you are in New York. You are in Trump's house. Trump, your country is here. In New York. And Trump, let me tell you. You see my leader. Do you see my leader? My leader is your savior. Before you go to God, I'm God. Now, let's see what is going to happen. Do you see? You see this Taliban, this Boko Haram, this terrorist you people are looking for. Every time you are looking for terrorists, looking for that. But all of them are here in our land. Instead of you to arrange my leader, and arrange with him very clear because my leader just said he has said he is the most powerful man on this planet and no other person. But with him around you, you are there. I'm telling you. For you to see my leader around you, Trump, it is a mark of respect for you. Thank God that you see to go to Gadiam. Nonsense. You are telling us, you're declared Jaffa. Wait, you're going to be immediately they shoot us, but we will shoot them back. And they will run. You are going to see how they will run. Every network will see. We are competent enough that this. This Taliban is out of power. Right there. Oko si sade gawaya di teo. That is why I think that you see this Biafra we are looking for. Biafra will not come unless you are honest with them. Their mind must be clear. That is why they are. Just do the move for now. We are going to show these people that they are just ordinary rulers. We are going to approve them. Listen, Zechariah, chapter 9, verse 9 is important. See that. Zechariah chapter 10, 1 to end. Zechariah chapter 11, 1 to end. Don't go and study it. Say, get ready to today because anything might happen any moment from now. Today, from today, we are marching to the war. Everyone is strong. If you know you love Biafra, it's now that you will be at the side of my leader as our ally. Because any nation that do not support Biafra will be this time. Nathaniel, I love you so much. What you will do now is to arrange with my leader because.
Unfortunately, we missed that caller, but we must continue. Caller on WhatsApp.
Hello, my lord.
Yeah, monitoring spirit. Go ahead.
Good morning. We are friends all over the world. May Ekekero Wachukwu Kabiyama bless you and bless our leader and protect him for everywhere he is going. The Chukwu Kabiyama will protect him and guide him and keep on guiding him on what to do and what not to do. May Ekekero Wachukwu bless every IPOB, the hardcore ones. The ones that are not there to scatter things, the Chukwu Kabiyama bless all of you. My name is Girik, I'm calling from Enugu province of Biafra land. You have mentioned the five enemies that are fighting Biafra. The five, but the one that I don't even know how to describe them is those ones that are talking rubbish. That I see nothing at IPOB that that are fighting for their freedom at this stage. They're still laughing. If you see them laugh, you see their stupidity upon their forehead, written, bold. I don't know how to describe those words. And those churches in the Biafra land, in the Enugu province here, in Biafra, that are still converging, doing fasting and praying several days dry for Nigeria to be peaceful. I don't know how to describe those words. I don't know how to describe this. Upon this time that Radio Biafra is everywhere, you click your internet, you see Radio Biafra, you listen to it, and you hear the truth. They are still fighting in that direction, and they are praying for Nigeria to be good for their Jubilee leader, Aka Buhari. I'm just tired of those people. Because if you are spreading the gospel of Biafra, they will be telling you all sorts of nonsense. They are laughing. They are smiling. They are laughing. They are just talking rubbish about Biafra.
So I don't know how to look at
those people.
Things are moving but forward. They will feel it.
Yeah.
I think it's getting so closer now. Let them be fast and full investment is coming for them. Let them start. We need 50 days fasting.
I'm so happy that we are not giving up. Many are not giving up. Those on fuse who are fear have cut up their brain. So much fear have caught up with them. But many are standing strong, and we must continue. Biafra must be restored, whether they like it, whether they don't like it. Those that are converging with Nigerians, those inside, those outside. The greatest is those that is inside, muchly those that is in IPOB. But we must fight them till the end. Who dictate them? I know the spirit of Biafra always helps us to dictate them, even when you think that they have zeal. You will see them. We will dictate them. We will continue until we fight all those inside. And the enemies outside is nonsense. All those Fulani that are afraid of Igbo people. Even one man can chase them out of out of Biafra land. It's just those that are inside that are calling them, telling them to come or to come. They know where their brothers be. That is the people that we are fighting. If for this, if left and Britain that are flying there, before they could fly there, this thing and find Mediterranean Sea. We are seeing them in Mediterranean Sea. We are everywhere. May AKK watch cook, have them a blessing, my Lord. Thank you for the good things you are doing for Biafra. Keep on keeping on. We are going back to our
God is faithful.
And we must continue. Thank you.
Call on WhatsApp. Are you still there?
Yes, I'm there. My able lecturer, Mad George Oyibe.
Good morning from here. Go ahead, please.
First of all, my name is Mazi HK. I'm calling from Navy Mumbai, India. Here, I hear from Ohaimezi in Eziago in Enugu State in Biafra land. Mazi, I thank you so much. Your topic this morning is quite interesting. It's very, very okay. Mazi, please don't quote me wrong. I have to mention one or two things. You know this Biafran of a thing, you get me. We don't know where we are because 100 years is not a year. That is why many people is mesmerizing. That is why
we
many
have
people
finished us already now. We have finished us over 200 years. Do you know what it means to delete the name of a country from the map? This idiot are fighting us indirectly. They did the same thing to Israel.
So,
they removed Israel from the map.
If not Trump, so Mazi, I thank you all. It's not easy, Mazi, because even some people here, and that is why I tell some people, stop saying it. Those people you call, see, my brother, this is Biafra, they say you Biafra of a thing. Leave them. They say ignorance is a disease. Ignorance is a disease.
Ignorance now is a cholera virus. Ignorance now is a cholera virus.
Because okay, look at let me start. That is why I say don't quote me wrong, because I'll take it bit by bit. Okay, look at now. I follow Mazen Nambekano from 2012. Now, when Mazen Nambekano started, many people call him, he's a jobless man, he don't have anything in his blood, that's why he want to destroy the youth of Nigeria, all this and that. After 2012, you know what happened? If you can go back to that, I have all those scripts because I used to record his script whenever he comes online. So do you know after that period, do you know how many people that he shared between 2012 to 2013? Yeah, very good number. After that, I know many people that is talking about against now they can today are more than after that we come to another phrase. Do you know that Mazen Nambekano in 2008, they say our enemy they are coming out and we are going to adapt with one after the other. You can see those things coming out. Do you remember when they call us Miss Khan? Because we are protesting our freedom. Freedom now is not hate speech. Freedom now is no more for anybody to agitate for freedom because we are protesting that shutdown. Okay, now, please tell us they are protesting. Are they not Miss Khan? It's like the way we are putting our right up on Twitter. Many people, I thank God. God, from anywhere you are, I thank you. Are you bringing out a person like Mazen Nambekano? Mazen is not, yes, anybody in our not anybody. The way to finish, we are not seeing any joy because we are still alive, like a dead man. Because things can happen to you at any time, no accountability. So, Mazen, I thank you all. I encourage you, continue doing it. No matter where we come to, we must continue seeing those saboteurs because the hand that is against this square is not a small hand. These are the most devil people on earth. That is why they use Roman Catholic, destroying freedom everywhere around the world. That is why I'm a Roman Catholic. I'm born and raised in Roman Catholic. I have a reason in my field. But I said all those things, you are worse than devil. Because you see evil and you welcome it and don't call evil and evil. You are not pampering. You need to one Nigeria, one Nigeria. I see what Nigeria is doing. See many people that have cut many trees down. You see chairman of plants. Where they beheaded that plant. If it is a Muslim man, he's being killed in that way. You think that all the land will contain all of you? Shame to all of you that call yourself pastors and priests. Modest is coming on to you. You will know that Mazen Nambekano is the prophet. Mazi, I want to stop here because I'm very, very annoyed. Because whenever I remember all those things, Mazi, I move out of emotion. Mazi, thank you. I
Thank you. Man. We must continue. Caller on the line. Are you there? But of course, that is Zoo Epileptic Network. We must continue. Call on WhatsApp. Are you there? Call on WhatsApp.
Yeah, I'm as well, you better. Good afternoon, sir.
Good morning from here. Go ahead, please.
I'm Mazen GK, calling from Malaysia. What I have to say this afternoon is that Andy, who they call Kenneth Okonkwo. Kenneth Okonkwo has been a failure. You don't have money to buy the form for governorship in Enugu State. PDP, Adam Oshimole rubbish him. Now he has come out again. They will still rubbish him again. Let him have it in mind, they will still rubbish him again. He will not even though the Nigeria will end today or tomorrow in the next circles, Kenneth Okonkwo cannot be relevant. Kenneth Okonkwo, whatever I tell him today, Okonkwo cannot. He cannot be a counselor. Those that are still promoting him in the movie industry, I'm very sorry for you people. The more you watch his film, the more he make money. Stop
what you believe in that can occur. Stop anything to patronize that idiot. He is nobody. Anything can occur is to stop patronizing him. He's nobody. He went and married the wife of the daughter of CPN, Christian CPN, OP CPN. After I'm divorced, you know already eat shit with that your big gutter mouth. You already eat shit. A generation, do you know what is a region? You are telling person the passport you will hold, even the and search you thoroughly. Do you know what people are passing through for using that passport in abroad? You beg the gutter to come and tell us. Look at your president has, they are giving banned the largest population of black nation in the world. They are banning you not to enter US. What you are signing another policy for free for visa arrival in your country. And because of that thing, they banned you. For you to see that these people are cowardly brain, and you go ahead to sign that document, there is no problem. At the end of the day, we will see what will come out of it. Brutal Tukru, the army chief, I'm asking you, where is Kabiru Sokoto? The one that bombed Catholic Church in Suleja, where is Kabiru Sokoto? Do you know that this APC government went and bought house for him in Dubai? No less than 500 to 1 million people. But he saw we are enjoying. He saw we are enjoying. Well, our people are lavishing in cell, dying in cell because of every flag. It will never be well for you. Every of our politicians that are raising up, fighting our people, it will never be well for you. The whole money you save, you will not eat it. If whatever the young chopper you have defeated to APC, can you imagine? What shall it profit you? You gain the whole world and lose your soul. The only project for more than 12 years you became a senator, the only project you do in your place is borehole. Borehole that is not up to 1 million naira. Come here in Port Harcourt, we do borehole. Borehole, 120,000. We said borehole, 120,000. Some people will collect 100,000.
60,000.
That is, okay, God bless you. Is a project that you do for people. You have defeated to APC. What are you looking for? You have no less than 30 something building all over the world. I don't want to make the amount you have saved for yourself. What are you defeating to APC? You can't stand and fight for your people. I want all of us to see what they are. They don't care about us. They don't want to know what we are doing. If you like, go and die. So far, you are not in charge. They don't care about you. But they are occupying our position. The position they are there is our own position. And you people are clapping hands for them, calling them chairman. They will tell you they will put water for you. It's not their money. It's my money and your own money. Our taxpayer money. That is what they are using. And you people foolishly following them. Why are you people following them? Eh? Why are you people following them? Why are you people following them? They will come and fly everything. You people will be following them. Their children will come tomorrow and pass your children. You people cannot... still following them. Let this thing and go. Let every person go. You people stupidly following them. You will never be well with you people. God will punish you people. God will punish you people. Why you leave it? I'm okay here.
Thank you.
God bless you people.
Caller on the line. Caller on the line. Caller on the line. Call on WhatsApp.
Good morning.
Good morning from here. Go ahead, please.
Thomas George Onibu, please. I'm calling from Okanambra State. My name is Mrs. Chinyi Renweke. I want to join IPOB. It's my problem. It's not around here where I'm living.
Okay. Have you forwarded your details to me?
No, I'm not with the that number you usually called. That's 7070.
Do you have them with you there?
Hello?
Do you have pen with you?
If I have what?
Pen. Biro.
Yes, yes.
Take the WhatsApp number down.
Okay, yeah.
070.
Yes.
815.
815, yes.
456.
452, yes.
No, 6. 456. 456.
452 again.
Not 2. 456.
Can I hear this word?
Let me start again. 070.
Okay. Yes.
815.
Yes.
456.
Yes.
42.
42.
Yes.
42. Okay, let me call it out. 070.
Yes.
815.
Yes.
452.
No, 456.
6.
Yes.
Okay, okay. 456.
Yes.
Then what?
42.
Okay, 42. Okay, let me call it out again. 070.
Correct.
815.
Correct.
456.
Correct.
42.
Correct.
Yeah, so thank you very
send
much.
Me your name, your phone number, and your location to that WhatsApp line. I will follow it up from there.
Okay, God bless you.
Thank you
for the work you have been doing. Thank you. Bye bye.
We must continue. Call our WhatsApp. Are you still there?
Thomas, good morning.
Good morning from here. Go ahead, please.
My name is Chukwu. I come from Holland. Maz, I hear all the points that you raised this morning. Chukwu, I'm blessed. I'm blessed, Maz, and the Kano. And all IPO will be working very hard to restore our land. This morning, what I try to say this morning is that people, this Hausa Fulani and Yoruba think that they can just push us in anywhere they like. When time they like to do anything, they do it to us because we are nobody. We are afraid of war because we already fight war. We don't want to fight war again. Imagine this Amoteko. That is where my anger is. People will call for this. They say, oh, Yoruba, they are right this. Okay, they are supporting us now. These people are evil we have now. These people are the most evil we have. When the Mazinand can rise up to say, okay, we are trying to defend our land. These people write a lot of nonsense and stupid things, write a lot of it, but nobody knows. They sabotage another one after World War. They sabotage again. Go underground, open their own security. You are telling us that we cannot have the security, but now our people is good to kill. I urge all the Biafrans, anywhere you stand, I don't want to see all this nonsense. Someone will arrest Hausa Fulani and be taken to police station after he kills somebody, after he made him, after he destroyed him. Kill him. Nothing will happen. Kill the Hausa Fulani because all this now is coming too much. It's coming too much. My eye are weeping blood. If I see anybody that is not kill any one person in Eastern region, the whole Biafra land, if you go to any Hausa Fulani, whether he's on the road anywhere, kill him too. Let them prepare, come and try to break. We are waiting. That war will start that place. Let them come there, kill one person. These people, the way these people are going, I think it is coming closer. The way they are going, because everybody have blood. All the whole police, nobody, we don't know. We can find any of their family, anywhere they live. They don't live in heaven. All the whole GSS, they don't live in heaven. They live in this earth. They live inside that Nigeria. They will see all that they are looking for. One by one, we will come to them. Mazu, hello, good morning.
Thank you, okay. We must continue. Call on the line.
Yeah, George, you good morning to you, sir.
Good morning from here. Go ahead, please.
Yeah, this is Otebi after calling from Ahabayaba, and it's land, my brother. I thank you for the good work that you are doing for us. You are too much. What you are doing in our land here, you are too much. Go ahead, my brother. Just like what you
are discussing this morning.
Because, you know, if not our leader, by this time around, we don't finish because after many, many years in which British and France, the whole world joined hands to fight a tiny dear France. They joined hands to fight a tiny dear France because of the West that put Caribbean and give to us. They know that it's not our fault. It's a put Caribbean that started to bless and who we bless. But the whole world are angry on us. But the Chipo Caribbean is going to destroy them as well. For them to keep quiet, for the whole world, for Africa as well to keep quiet. For somebody to come from British will come and name us One Nigeria here, on which they know that there is nobody there to name One Nigeria. And they come and name us. They enslave us. These people, they bring fight for us for in our land here, on which the whole world are watching. They bring fight for us for here. We did not do this to anything. We did not want to conquer anybody. We did not have any of their, and we did not see any of their property. But these people, British, France, and Nigeria, which are also planning to do to us, they decided to conquer our generation that time. If those are the generation that they wipe out, they kill out, they still be alive today, don't you know that the diaspora will be a that the diaspora is going to be a very good to us. But these people, they kill us because of the way that people carry them and give to us. But I thank our leader, how our leader takes to revise us back. Chukwu Adeoma is going to punish them this time around. British, you see this war that you are taking our land? You are taking, you want to make our land to be a theater war. This time around, British is not going to be an easier thing for you. You see those man you came that you normally watch on Saturday game? It's not going to be an easier game for you to take this fire that you are setting our land. You want to take this fire for our land. You people are going to see the run because this is not 1950. This is 2020, my brother. Mazoni, the people of them are continuing to bless you. We are here. Nothing will happen. The Biafra will die. The Biafra will bury. The Biafra we must come. Mazi, good morning to you for Biafra land here. Thank you.
Thank you very much. We must continue. Call on WhatsApp. Call on the line.
Hello. Good morning.
Good morning from here.
Mother, my name is Tima. I'm calling you from Abuja. I'm the leader. So I'll be having a little Biafra. Now I'm in Abuja, no contact at all. So on to join me, I still remember in Abuja.
Have you sent your data?
I'm sending message to this number several times.
I can't access any message on that phone. Send it to the WhatsApp.
I don't have your WhatsApp number. You know, I'm not listening to radio here.
Do you have a pen with you there?
Huh?
You have pen with you there?
Pen.
You get biro.
Yes.
Oh, you're right and down.
Okay.
070-815-456-426-426-42. Yes, that is the WhatsApp number.
Okay.
So send me a message, your name, your phone number, and where you did. Send down to that WhatsApp number, we'll follow it up from there.
Okay.
Thank you very much. Caller on WhatsApp.
Good afternoon, my rep. I'm calling here from Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia. My name is Ezekwem Uchechi. I'm from Okigwe Province, Biafra Land. My rep, actually, a lot of things are happening, and you come and think of it. These people, they killed us. And 2000, and the one that they kept the record, which I knew since that time, Operation Panther Dance or Operation Atelogwu or whatever, Operation Amadio or whatever they call it, are still going on since 14 September 2017 when they killed us last. That led to the death of our parents, whom we are planning to bury it. And now they are gathering to do what they have been doing again. Maybe this is a kind of a jealousy for them because we knew on 27th of January 2017, Buhari died and buried in Saudi Arabia. Maybe they are not happy because their own died. They could not bury him legitimately, legally, as the law stated. And also, maybe what they are doing right now is as a result of the visitation. Osibanjo, the second baboons and monkey. The monkey himself visited Abia State maybe a few weeks ago, early January. The results are playing out right now. But one thing we can assure them, These are our parents, and we must bury our parents, whether they like it or not. Our deputy always say, Uchemefo, that they shall never write agenda for us. We are the one going to write agenda for the zoo. As they are planning, they don't know what we are planning to. But whatever they are doing or planning, any kind of ammunition they like to send, let them send. IPOP have announced to the whole world that we are going to bury our parents on 14th of this month, comes next week, Friday, if I'm not mistaken. So all these things they are doing right now, they just want to provoke us again. They just want to make us to do what they feel that is suitable for them. But it's not going to work out that way for them anymore. Like you said last night, if they try to do what the nonsense they do, then their number is not going to be complete again. And we can assure them, it's not a threat. IPOP are the people that when they say something, they must go ahead and do what they said. Since this week, since last week, the media, the radio Biafra is boiling. We can see the pains, how our people, how it's affected them, what is unfolding in Biafra land. Nobody is happy. They just want to remind us of the wound they created on 14th of September 2017. That's what they are trying to remind us right now. But this time around, it will not be business as usual. That's what IPOP can assure them. I don't want to talk too much. My rep, please, if possible, I don't know. You can link me up with a brother that's always called from Malaysia, AGK Mechison. He always called. Please, if possible, you can tell him to contact him. Thank you very much. Just link me up. Let me talk to him.
Yes, okay.
God bless you.
Hopefully, this is where we draw the curtain for this morning segment. Dear friends across the globe, don't let anybody deceive you. We were born into this war. We didn't start it. We didn't cause it. Our crime is to be blessed by God. It's not our fault now. Don't you get what is playing out? Is it not clear to you? Do have a wonderful day as you go about your lawful business, irrespective of where you are. God be with you.
Did you know that since 1914 to date, up to 15 million Biafrans has been killed and massacred by the Islamic Republic of Nigeria?
And do you know that Nigeria is a zoo, a creation of a white man, and it has aspired?
We must fight to the end. I know the truth. Now we must live in this battle. And no surrender. Yes, we be dying. Now we be crying. Yes, for freedom all we need. To go keep the Adama God save us. Cause the children call on you. Yes, from us to be free. Free, free. Free from bondage. Yes, from us to be free. Free, free. Free from tyranny. Yes, from us to be free. Free, free. Free from Nigeria. They're from us to be free, 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 free from slavery. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be thy name. May thy kingdom come on earth, O Biafra. The time is now, I fight on you for me, devil soldiers. I can see the lights at the end of the tunnel. Victory is sure, no giving up, we are marching to the promised land. Oh, yeah, say no to one Nigeria. Oh, yeah, say no to Britain. Oh, yeah, say no to divide and rule. We say no to South. Listen, Nigeria, jaga, everything's got a starter. My people suffering and dying, so the best for my heart. See Yoruba, I was a Boko Haram killing us. Every day we be dying like a slave. Give me freedom, want to freedom. Wanna be free, free like a bird in the skies. We get friends all over the world, they cry. Now we call it, rescue us to go to Kabyama. We must fight to the end. I know the truth. Now we must live in this battle. And no surrender. Get from us to be free, free, free. Free from bondage. Yeah, from us to be free. Free, free. Free from Nigeria.
it's time for revolution. For the land of the rising sun. It's time for revolution. For the nation of Biafra. It's time for revolution. For the land of the rising sun. It's time for revolution. For the nation of Biafra. We must fight to the end. Now we must win this battle and no surrender. And from us to be free from bondage. And from us to be free from guilt. And from us to be free from Nigeria. Never must you be free from slavery.